Hi, everybody. Welcome again to A New Way to Museum. I'm Dr. Reese Barrick, director of the Sternberg Museum of Natural History. And today I'm here with Curtis Wolf, the director of the Kansas Wetlands Education Center. We're outside near Cheyenne Bottoms, which is a really cool wetlands area. And we're near Great Bend, Kansas. And one of the things we wanted to do today is know that museums aren't just indoors in dark, big buildings. So, Curtis, what is Cheyenne Bottoms?
Well, Cheyenne Bottoms, believe it or not, is the largest wetland on the interior of the United States. Who knew, right here in the middle of Kansas, that we have a giant wetland? And that's pretty awesome enough in itself, but having a wetland here is incredibly unique for this part of Kansas. And Cheyenne Bottoms provides just an interesting habitat for a lot of different organisms.
Yeah, it's kind of crazy. It's beautiful out here today. We're in November and we're at 70 degrees, so we have a really fun time to be out here. Right. Now, Cheyenne Bottoms is kind of unique because of what? What is Cheyenne Bottoms unique for?
Well, this time of year, we are in the perfect time for fall migration, and that's one of the things that Cheyenne Bottoms is really known for is the bird life that's here. And so that's what we're going to talk a little bit about today is all the birds that stop here on their migration.
Bird migration, that's cool. Well, what is migration?
So migration is basically a seasonal movement of animals from one location to another. And that's pretty much, it fits the definition for any type of organism that migrates.
Well, that's pretty cool. So birds are pretty special here. So how does Cheyenne Bottoms in general fit into bird migration? We're in the middle of Kansas. Where are they coming from and going to?
That's right. So we are on what's called the Central Flyway. The North American Central Flyway is kind of a giant bird highway as birds migrate. And so they follow very particular routes. Now, most of the birds that we get here that migrate through Cheyenne Bottoms are not your typical Kansas birds. They're not the birds that you're typically going to see at your feeder in your backyard or in a grassland. They're wetland birds. These are birds that spend most of their lives around oceans and shorelines. What are they doing in Kansas?
Yeah, what are they doing? There's no ocean in Kansas.
That's right.
Well, at least not since about 70 million years ago.
That's exactly right. But they are passing through this area. So in order for them to get from their winter range that might be on a coastline down in South America, and to get to their coastline habitat for their breeding season up on the Arctic Circle, they've got to pass through this area. And so that's what Cheyenne Bottoms provides them, is an area that provides the correct habitat for them. Wetlands here in Kansas are the closest thing we have to shorelines and beaches.
Man, that's a long migration. You think they get a little bit tired.
That's exactly
right. How often do they migrate?
Well, these birds are gonna be migrating twice a year. So during the spring, they're gonna head north to their breeding grounds. During the fall, they're heading south for their overwintering areas. And so the wetlands is just providing a stopover place. A lot of the birds that are here aren't here very long. They're not gonna be staying for weeks or even months. They're gonna be passing through, stopping for maybe a couple days, refueling, getting a lot of energy put onto their bodies so that they can make it to the next destination.
That's awesome. So with a bunch of weird birds that aren't normally found in Kansas, are there any really sort of cool stories of particular birds that pass through here?
There really are. There's some really neat birds that do stop through here. And right now we actually have one of the coolest birds that we get the most questions about, which are whooping cranes. Whooping cranes are the tallest bird in North America. They stand about 5 foot tall. They have a 7 foot wingspan. They're bright white birds. Very awesome to see. And there's only about 800 of them that exist in the world. In this flyway, this natural population is only about 500. And most of those, or a lot of them, will stop through this area. And this year has been a phenomenal whooping crane year. We've seen a lot of whooping cranes stop both here at Cheyenne Bottoms and the wetland that's just south of here called Quivira National Wildlife Refuge. And so they've stopped in. We've had several that have stopped and have been here for about a week. And they're just kind of fueling up until they get pushed further south. They're going to be heading to the Texas coast is where they overwinter at a place called Aransas National Wildlife Refuge.
Wow, that's very cool. So how do we learn about migrations? What do biologists do to be able to study what birds are migrating and how they get there?
Well, one of the best ways that scientists have tried to track where birds are going is by using bands. So they'll mark these birds.
It's like Metallica or no?
They put little leg bands or neck bands on the birds. And so these little metal bands are...
It is heavy metal.
Yeah, it's heavy metal. Heavy metal rock band here. So these bands go onto the bird's leg. Some other bands will go on their neck as a neck collar. And basically, once they're put on there, if that bird is found again through whatever way, that gives us some information about them. Now, that's kind of the lower technology side, but there's also some interesting technology with radio trackers. This is a radio collar for a goose that was used, and this is a radio transmitter that can actually transmit and give us a signal where the bird is, and they can actually track those. There's even a more advanced thing, and we've worked with the Nature Conservancy the last year to put up what's called a MODIS tower. MODIS towers are going up all over the United States and Europe and Canada, and it's a tower that if a bird has a little nano tag on it, and it gets within about 14 miles of the tower, two towers that are here at Cheyenne Bottoms, it sends a signal, and we're able to see that that bird is here and kind of track that it's in the area and how long it stays here. That's a really interesting piece of technology, and these little tags, the MODIS tags, they've made them so small that they can even be put on insects to track them.
Wow.
Which is some neat stuff, and I think there's going to be some neat research projects that we're able to get involved in the next few years.
So you're studying a lot of bird migration. What else migrates?
So, yeah, not just birds migrate. We actually have some awesome insects that migrate through here. And some of you might be familiar with monarch butterflies as one of the most well-known insect that migrates, but there's other insects that migrate too. And we actually tag them. We don't put a metal leg band on them, but we do use a little sticker tag that we can put on their wings. This is a program called Monarch Watch, which is done through the University of Kansas. And they've developed a little sticker system to tag monarch butterflies. And we have a big butterfly festival that we host here every fall when they're coming through, and have people tag the monarchs, release them, and then hopefully some of these tags are found down in Mexico where they overwinter.
That's very cool. So a question with all these tags, do you ever find birds that you've tagged one year and find them in multiple years?
That does happen. There are tagging stations around the country, and there isn't any real close by right here right now. But these tagging stations definitely are able to track and find these different bands as they come through. It happens, not very frequently, but it happens.
Now, I do know that you have hunting that goes on around here.
That's right.
So what happens if a hunter gets a bird that has a band or tag on it? Do they let you know, or is there anything that helps trace what happens to these birds?
So especially these metal bands, that is one of the things that the hunting community has really kind of gotten in on, and they know because there's hunters that harvest these birds. That's one way of getting birds back. And so a lot of the biologists that are waterfowl biologists, they capture waterfowl, especially up in the Dakotas and up in that area that we call the duck factory. And they'll catch birds, trap them, and put on these leg bands and release them. And then if a hunter harvests one of those birds, they will turn in the they'll turn in the tag. There's a phone number or a website on there for where they can go to actually report the band that they've gotten. And once they do that, they get all sorts of information back saying where the bird was banded, when, and that's the source of information that provides a lot of great info about where that bird's been.
So it's kind of cool. This is a new way to museum, and we're outside, but the fact that the birds are migrating through twice a year means that you're pretty much guaranteed, if you come in those two times a year, you can go out to the ponds at Cheyenne Bottoms and you're guaranteed to see a lot of birds, just like if you were going to a museum to see the exhibits.
That's right.
So are there a lot of tourists that travel from outside of the area to just come here specifically to see birds?
That's exactly right. Bird watchers, they will travel to see these things, and having a place like Cheyenne Bottoms really attracts a lot of the bird watchers to come in and find these birds. Bird watchers all have what's called life lists of birds. They keep track of the bird species that they've seen, and they like to check mark off as many of these birds as they can. And so coming to a place like Cheyenne Bottoms, where there's been, I think, 356 different species of birds that have been spotted here, you can come in during the migration times especially and really check off a lot of birds. And again, not birds that you would typically think you'd see in Kansas.
That's very cool. Well, one thing that's also neat here, besides the beautiful outdoors area, is, the Wetlands Education Center does have a building, does a lot of education programs. There is basically a museum with exhibits inside here. So I want to thank you for letting us know about Cheyenne Bottoms, the Wetlands Education Center, birds and migration. And we'll just go take a look inside so you can see a little bit more about what's in the Wetlands Education Center. And, you know, how do people get a hold of you if they want to come visit?
Absolutely. They can check us out on our website, which is wetlandscenter.fhsu.edu. We have a great Facebook page as well. You can search for the Kansas Wetlands on there. And you can call and call us, come down, make a trip down here and visit us too.
That's awesome. And you know, it's really cool because Curtis and the Wetlands Education Center, sort of a sister with the Sternberg Museum. We're all part of Fort Hays State University. And so we really love to be able to interact and collaborate on things. So let's go take a look inside. Well, hey everybody, we've popped inside here at the Wetlands Education Center. And as you can see, there's really cool exhibits. There's lots of things to see and learn about. Now, Curtis, when people come to Cheyenne Bottoms to go out and see the birds, they're kind of a long ways away. You need binoculars and things. How do you figure out what birds it is that you're looking at or where to even find them?
Biggest thing is practice, definitely. But you can learn about the birds here. We've got a great recent sightings board that we try to keep track of what people are seeing, and so you have an idea of what's out here. And from that, you can come in and look at some of the displays to get some tips and tricks on how to identify some of these.
That's very cool. So anyway, come check out the Kansas Wetlands Education Center. Come check out the Sternberg. And thank you for joining us for A New Way to Museum. We'll see you again next time.
Thanks for joining us in A New Way to Museum with the Sternberg Museum of Natural History. If you enjoyed this video, like it and subscribe to our channel. Hit the bell for notifications when we release a new video. Support us on Patreon for early access and exclusive content. You can also follow us on all our social media. Links are found in the description. Thanks for watching, and follow your curiosity to new discoveries.